We've talked about Jemele Hill a few times, and now she has not gone after, had some fun with LeVar Ball. So in case you've been living under a rock, here's what LeVar Ball recently said. And this is to Donatus Urbonus. LeVar Ball and his big plan on how he's going to bring Lonzo, Melo, and Jello to one team. Lonzo will be on his third year, and I want to let every NBA team know that Lonzo is not going to re-sign with the Lakers, but will go to any team that will take all three of my boys. Here we go. And we continue on. So LeVar Ball was asked about this. He caught up with TMZ after he landed at LAX. Here's that.
If your other two sons aren't signed by the
Man,
Lakers.
Who don't want their sons to play all on the same team? Tell me a father who don't want their son to play on the same team.
But will Lonzo.
Name one father who don't want their sons to play on the same team.
But will Lonzo leave if they don't get their way? If you don't get your way?
I'll let y'all figure that out.
Well, aren't you afraid Magic Johnson's
gonna... I ain't never afraid of nothing.
All right, well...
I ain't never afraid of nothing. I'm a big baller. I don't get afraid of nothing.
Has Magic said anything to you about your comments?
Did he say anything to you?
He hasn't got back to me.
Big baller player!
Whenever you bring Robert on, you know that it's going to come out at some point in time. Okay, so Jemele Hill was then asked about it on Jalen and Jacoby and what she thinks about LeVar Ball, and here's what she had to say about the matter.
Should we cover the crazy things that LeVar Ball says on Jalen and Jacoby?
I rule you should, because yes, I do. Look, love him or hate him, LeVar Ball resonates with people. He's polarizing, he's topical, and I don't love everything that comes out of his mouth either. He's like the drunk uncle at the picnic, right?
Correct.
Okay, you gotta treat him as such.
And I'm disappointed in ESPN and the NBA. No way that LeVar Ball should not be participating in the celebrity game.
Okay, we'll get to that in a second. Firstly, I love the glasses that Jalen Rose has. Those are tight as hell.
I was gonna bring up the glasses too.
I wish I could.
I was gonna have the opposite opinion, but I hate you.
You hate him?
I mean, I'm not gonna tell him not to. I'm just.
I think it's a good look.
I would, if I was his stylist, I would be like, let's go with a different frame.
I'll be sure to tell him that over All-Star Game weekend. Is LeVar Ball the drunk uncle at the picnic, boys?
No, he's very calculated. He knows exactly what he's saying and what he's saying and when he's saying it. He's having fun. You see how much he smiled during that whole walk? He goes, oh, here comes Team Z. Okay. And the thing is, as Jemele Hill said, he's polarizing and he has a place there. I'm having fun with this. I've had issues with things. The main thing I've had issue with what he's done is, I don't know if it's even forcing, but talking his youngest two sons into doing things his way. And I think he should let them kind of navigate their lives a bit more. That's the only thing, but that's only because I think it affects his sons.
He would not do a fan of the move to Lithuania.
That was just me, but I mean, now these
I'm asking cool you. Me.
No, that's what we're talking about before when it happened.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
I was against it. Okay. But those aren't my kids. But I was just I think for their progression and their path to the league, mm-hmm. potentially, let them do it their own way and see what happens, you know?
Yeah.
But everything he says just doesn't bother me. I enjoy it now.
Well, here's the thing. Haven't we seen this story before already? That he tried to get all three of them signed to a shoe deal, and no shoe company wanted any part of that deal at all.
I didn't know.
So Lonzo just went back to BBB.
Oh.
No. He was like, you need to take all three of my boys, and it's gonna be, what was it, $1 billion is something that he wanted,
yeah,
right?
The thing with LeVar is you have to separate the WWE stuff from the real stuff. Like, so when he says stuff like that, first off, Lonzo, because of the way the NBA contracts are, he can't be a real free agent for like 7 years. What are you talking about? Like, you know, restricted free agency and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I think people, you know what happens? Here's what happens. In media, we're waiting for LeVar.
Yeah.
We want him to say something. They know it's not that serious, but they're waiting. That's why TMZ is there. And LeVar knows that they're waiting for him as well. He can't just come out there and say, man, I hope Lonzo gets healthy and the Lakers play well. We wouldn't be talking about him right now, would we?
They would be disappointed. They'd be like, what's up with that?
Totally. That's
it. You got to say something important. And my thing is, like I say, separate the WWE from the real stuff. A year and a half ago, we didn't know who LeVar Ball was. We barely knew who Lonzo was. We didn't know LaMelo and we didn't know LiAngelo. Right now, in February of 2018, they're making millions of dollars from Facebook. They're making a lot of money from sponsorships. Lonzo, even though his play's been uneven, one of the most popular you know, players in the NBA.
Lonzo Wednesday. Yeah.
LiAngelo and LaMelo are more popular than any other college basketball player, probably not named Trae Young right now, and probably more, if you want to call it worldwide popularity, right, than them. And they have never played a college game. He did all of that. So it's promotion. And I think people that take it too seriously, either A, they just are like that, or B, somebody, you gotta, you know, act like it's really bothering you because that's how you rile up your fan base. And, my God, LaVar's the worst thing that's ever. He's gonna ruin the NBA. He's gonna ruin the Lakers. None of that matters, you know? I mean, not yet.
For like 4 years until, you know, we get an answer.
I said this from the beginning.
Yeah.
Big Baller Brand lives.
Wait, what is it?
Big Baller Brand lives and dies with how Lonzo Ball ends up being in the NBA.
I agree.
If he doesn't have to be LeBron James, he doesn't have to be Russell Westbrook, doesn't have to be Kevin Durant. If he is close, just close to an all-star level, and the Lakers get good at some point, you're going to be listening to LeVar Ball for the next 10 to 15
what,
years.
What level point guard in the NBA now does he have to, what's the lowest, compare him to one that's at, it's the lowest level of success he has to have. Like, I'm thinking like Austin Rivers.
Oh,
what if he's that good?
Dude, way better.
On the cusp of starting.
Austin is also a shooting guard, but I understand what you're saying.
If he's Conley, you know, with the Grizzlies. Okay. Like
Mike Conley's a damn good player.
I mean, but, you know, like you say, when you start talking
knowledge and popularity.
Right. When you start talking about best point guards, you get down to him after a little level. Like I said, they're so popular, they don't have to be great. They just can't be like super bust.
Can I make a comparison? Yeah. I would say not even level of popularity, because we talked about this a few days ago, where Mike Conley's popularity is drained by just being in Memphis.
Yeah.
Like, he got the highest paid contract, and JR and I still view him as an underrated point guard. I would make the comparison from a popularity standpoint, a game standpoint, not points per game. I don't think he can shoot like that. But like Reggie Jackson.
Yeah.
Who's like a pretty good point guard. Yeah, he's the second option on the team.
He can be Patrick now the third. Beverly. I mean, he has so much popularity, and that brand is ascending. As long if he does, like right now, what was he, like 10-7-7? If he ever gets that up to 15-8-8.
Oh my God. We're talking like not literally, but like Hall of Fame, Lonzo Ball.
For making money purposes, one game winning shot.
One game winning shot. If the Lakers ever get into the playoffs, because you can see the energy from the Lakers right now, even though they're not good. You can see the energy from people feeling like they're right on the cusp. And if they get over that, I'll put it like this. If you're LeBron James, if you come to the Lakers, now I don't know what LeBron is thinking right now, but LeBron coming to the Lakers would only make LeVar massive amount of money. Anything that would bring the Lakers back into prominence, even if it's Paul George, doesn't matter who it is. A Lakers, a Lonzo, a Ball, Magic Johnson, it's a mix, and the gumbo is in the bowl. It's just, is it going to have enough season?
They're in the right city with the right team for this to blow.
Yeah.
Would they also make enough money off each other where it would be equated to a tremendous success for both parties?
Yeah, I think so. I mean,
JR's unsure.
We don't know how much they're really making. We know they're getting we know the brand is strong. I always tell people like that, your brand doesn't necessarily mean your bank account. You know, it's two different Bs. Mm-hmm. You know, everybody can know you. That's like IG models. Like, they can have 500,000 followers and everybody in their DM and be sleeping on the couch in the house with no refrigerator.
All right.
So your brand can be strong, but your money may not be. So we don't know. I think it's so early, but we want to jump to conclusions so fast.
Because LeBron James is going to be a free agent this next year.
Well,
that's
like
why.
I said, these
we can
next,
jump to it.
The NBA is going to be great for a long time because of the drama. And they should thank LaVar Ball because he keeps them, and the Lakers should thank LaVar Ball because he keeps them in the news.
And pettiness.
And pettiness. Yeah. We all love pettiness.
Yeah, of course.
I'm having fun.
Real quick, so with the Los Angeles Lakers, is there any chance whatsoever that Lonzo will not be a Los Angeles Laker after 3 or 4 years? Going further with what LaVar said.
Only, not because of LaVar. It would only be because Lonzo turns out to be Emmanuel Moody or something. You know, like, it just doesn't work out. It won't have anything. It would have to do with strictly.
It would have nothing to do with LeVar. It'd have to do with his own performance.
Yeah, if his own performance is something where they say, you know something, we blew this pick. Mm-hmm. We're going to, and they would, you know, trade him. They would trade him before anything, you know, else. I don't think no one's going to say, hey, Lonzo Ball is averaging 10 assists a game. Let's get rid of him because of LaVar Ball. That will never happen.
Yeah. No one was worried about when they were talking about potential trades with the Lakers when the Cavs made their whole shift. Mm. No one was worried that Lonzo might be in the mix. No, they're solidly with him. And again, it's just a matter of it's his performance based. And even if it, again, he can be moderately performance based. Because again, the reason why the Clippers, when they were in the disastrous years, still were one of the most successful financial franchises in all of the whole sport, because of where they were and just the matter that they could just bring in that much. So when you have a popularity thing going, you're like, oh, we'll take that money. That works for me.
Isn't it weird how we kind of miss those days of the Los Angeles Clippers?
I don't.
With Darius Miles and Corey Maggette. You don't?
No.
The failed draft pick of Michael Olowokandi.
No. Did you know Darius Miles had a gold-plated barber's chair? If you want to know why he went.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, they had to put all this stuff up for auction.
I ask you a question. Why would I know that?
Well, you're supposed to know these things.
Yeah, I know. I am supposed to know these things.
He had
a gold-plated chair?
Yeah, like, you know, to get his hair cut. He had, like, a barber studio in the house.
King of the Kessler.
Yeah, King of the Kessler. Yeah, you know, I'm a Seinfeld guy, so I know a lot about nothing. But, yeah, when he lost all his money, they had to auction off a bunch of his stuff, and he had a lot of weird stuff. And
were you in the running for it?
I thought about it. I mean, they were giving it away for like $30. I would want to go on throne. I'm the Black Panther.
You know who hasn't seen that movie and won't?
Laura Ingraham.
All right, let us know your thoughts. Comment section below. Subscribe to T-Watch Sports.